I'm Deborah Borchardt, and this is your Marijuana Money Minute. This week, Curaleaf announced a $34 million offering, and then they followed up with that, announcing that they had closed on their Grassroots acquisition. They had announced a year ago that they were buying Grassroots, but it took till now to close the deal. Having said that, now that it's done, they are one of the largest cannabis companies. They have 135 dispensary licenses and 88 operational dispensaries. We also got earnings from Organigram this week. The company reported that their sales fell to $18 million from last year's $24 million for the same time period, and their net losses jumped over 700% to $89 million. The company blamed the drop in revenues on changing customer preferences, that they wanted more value-oriented products, and they had those, but they didn't get them to the shelf until late in the quarter. The FDA issued draft guidance this week for research related around cannabinoid products. They are taking comments and suggestions for the next 60 days. We also have a lot of legal things to go over this week. MaryMed lost a round with the bankrupt Kentucky hemp company, Gencana. Now, MaryMed was one of their largest shareholders, and they were trying to assert their power in the running of the company, but a judge said, nope, Gencana had already sold most of their assets, and so MaryMed really had no power. And that is a stark reminder that shareholders come last in bankruptcy cases. Earth Communications and Andrew Hogg were told to cease and desist by the SEC. Earth Communications had been tweeting and sending out stock promotions and not disclosing that they were paid to do so. In Nevada, a new regulator, Cannabis Compliance Board, levied some fines on CW Nevada. They had not been paying their taxes, and then when they investigated them, they found all kinds of things going wrong at that company. You can read that on Green Market Report. Anyway, they were fined to pay the back taxes and fined for all of their misdeeds and told to relinquish those licenses. In stock move, Europe's largest independent cannabis company, Enac Life Sciences Limited, became a publicly traded company on the NASDAQ with a merger with the Anda Acquisition Corp. 3, and Willow Biosciences was approved to start trading on the OTC with the ticker symbol CANSF. And that's it for this week. I'm Deborah Borchardt for the Green Market Report.